Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Most Merciful, the Most Beneficent. Dear students of class 9, this is the continuation part of Qaid, Great Leader. Let's come for the idiomatic translation of your paragraph 5 from your book. There was much in those days of violence to sadden Jinnah. Un dinon mein بہت زیادہ تشدد تھا قائد اعظم کو افسردہ کرنے کے لیے. Who was a man of very strong feeling, جو بہت مضبوط احساسات کے شخص تھے. Although he rarely showed it, اگرچہ کہ وہ کبھی کبھار اس کا اظہار کرتے تھے. Yet those who were close to him on Independence Day, اگرچہ کہ وہ لوگ جو یوم آزادی پر ان کے قریب تھے. Sometimes saw for a few moments a happier man, انہوں نے کچھ لمحے کے لیے ایک خوش کن آدمی کو دیکھا یا ایک خوش مزاج آدمی کو دیکھا. Once he went to the balcony of governor house, ایک دفعہ وہ گورنر ہاؤس کی بالکونی میں گئے. From where he could see without being seen, جہاں پہ وہ بغیر دکھائی دیے دیکھ رہے تھے. And as he looked on the crowd, اور جیسا ہی وہ ہجوم کی طرف دیکھ رہے تھے. Still cheering in the street outside, باہر گلیوں میں وہ ابھی تک بھی خوشی سے چلا رہے تھے. اینڈ ہی اسمائل, وہ مسکرائے. ان دیٹ اسمائل کوڈ بی سین دا وارم ہارٹیڈ مین بیہائنڈ دی سٹینڈ قائد اعظم, اس مسکراہٹ کے پیچھے ایک گرم جوش شخص دکھائی دیا سخت گیر قائد اعظم کے پیچھے. اوکے اسٹوڈنٹ, ان دیز لائنس یو آر ٹولڈ دیٹ there was much violence in those days to make Jinnah sad, because during the partition, when the Indians were migrating towards when the Hindus were migrating towards India, and when the Muslims were migrating towards Pakistan, there were much violence on railway stations, on roads, on borders, and everywhere. So this was the factor that saddened Jinnah very much. Although he was a very man of very strong feelings, and he did not show his feelings, but still it was apparent with his personality that he was much sad about that situation. And it is described here that in those days of independence, the people who were very close to him saw for a few moments a happier man, because he was happy for the independence of Pakistan. So here is an event that is telling that once he went to the balcony of a governor house where he was living, and from the balcony he can see the vast number of people, but he cannot be seen by people. It's mean that he was standing on a hidden place and he was not being seen by the people, and he looked at the crowd from there and outside in the street. So he got smile at their happiness and at their cheering, and behind that smile a warm-hearted man can be seen, although he was a very stern sort of a man. Okay, paragraph 6. Muhammad Ali Jinnah was at that time tired and far from well. Muhammad Ali Jinnah اس وقت بہت تھک چکے تھے اور صحت کی حالت میں نہیں تھے. Far from well یعنی اچھی صحت میں نہیں تھے. But he had the satisfaction of knowing that the greater part of his work was done by the force of his determination and leadership. لیکن وہ یہ بات جانتے تھے کہ ان کے کام کا بیشتر حصہ مکمل ہو چکا ہے ان کی قوت سے اور قوت ارادی سے اور ان کی رہنمائی سے. فار پیپل ہو ہیڈ ونس بین ڈیفیٹیڈ گروپ, کہ ایک وہ لوگ جو ایک کبھی شکست خوردہ گروپ تھا. وتھ لٹل ٹو ہوپ, ان کے پاس بہت کم امید تھی. فار ان امپائر, اور وہ ایک سلطنت کے اندر رول بائی دا فارن پاور, ان کے اوپر بیرونی تسلط تھا. ہیڈ بیکم دا گریٹسٹ آف دا مسلم اسٹیٹس, وہ اب ایک عظیم مسلم ریاست بن چکے تھے. اینڈ ففتھ لارجسٹ نیشن آف دا ورلڈ, اور دنیا کی پانچویں بڑی طاقت. ہیئر آئی ایم گوئنگ ٹو ریمائنڈ یو دیٹ ناؤ پاکستان از ناٹ دا لارجسٹ نیشن آف دا مسلم ورلڈ, بیکاز ایٹ دا ٹائم آف پارٹیشن بنگلہ دیش اینڈ پاکستان بوتھ فار دا جوائنٹ پارٹ That's why it became the one of the largest Muslim states. But it's after the fall of Dhaka, now the Muslims were not the greater sixth nation of the world. So in this paragraph, you are told that Qaed Azam was not in a good health. He had done a lot of work for the creation of Pakistan. So after completing this task, he was not in a good health condition, but still he was satisfied that he had performed his task. He has performed his part and got independence for the Muslims. And the Muslims were the group that were empowered by the foreigners, the Britishers. But after this independence, they had become the largest and the fifth largest nation of the world, or the fifth largest Muslim state of the world. Okay, continuation of paragraph 6. 70 million people who once had no country to call their own. 70 million log जो के वंस हैड नो कंट्री टू कॉल देयर ओन, उनका कोई मुल्क नहीं था जिसे वो अपना कहें. हैड बिकम एन नेशन विद ग्रेट आइडियाज एंड ग्रेट फेथ. अब वो एक अजीम कौम बन चुके थे जिनके अजीम ख्यालात और अजीम और पुख्ता यकीन था. फ्यू डेज आफ्टर ही लैंडेड इन कराची, कराची में की आमद के कुछ दिन के बाद, मोहम्मद अली जिन्ना टोल्ड हिज पीपल, मोहम्मद अली जिन्ना ने अपने लोगों को बताया, यू आर फ्री टू गो टू योर टेम्पल्स, आप अपने मंदिरों में जाने के लिए आज़ाद हैं. यू आर फ्री टू गो टू योर मॉस्क्स और एनी अदर प्लेस ऑफ वर्शिप, आप अपनी मस्जिदों में या इबादत की किसी भी और जगह में जाने के लिए इन दिस स्टेट ऑफ पाकिस्तान, पाकिस्तान की इस रियासत में आज़ाद हैं. यू मे बिलोंग टू एनी रिलीजन और कास्ट, आपका किसी भी कौमियत या मज़हब से ताल्लुक हो. वी ऑल आर सिटीजन ऑफ वन स्टेट, हम सब एक ही रियासत के बाशिंदे हैं. He was of course reminding them the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's teaching. Yakeenan wo unhe Rasool sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki talimat bayan kar rahe the. That all men are equal in the eyes of Allah, ke tamam log Allah ki nazar mein yaksa hain ya ek hain. Okay, when Pakistan was not came into being, there was 70 million people who had no country, 70 million Muslims who had no country. But now, after the hard work of Qaed Azam, those people were capable to call a country for their own, and they can visualize and idealize, and they can prevent their faith in this country. So after when he came to Pakistan, he addressed to the people of Pakistan that you are free to go to your temples, to your mosques, or any other places of worship here. It means that there were majority were Muslims, but there were minorities in the country as well. So he talked about the rights of those minorities, that they also can profess their own religions, and he declared that there should be no difference of caste and creed in this state of Pakistan. So he reminded them the teachings of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that when he created the ideal state of Medina, so in that state of Medina, he declared the people that all men are equal in the eyes of Allah. So the rights of idolaters, the rights of Christians, Jews, and all should be protected under the laws of the state. So of course, these were the teachings of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Qaed Azam here remind those teaching to the people that all people are equal in the state of Pakistan. Thank you so much for listening.